You have to think that Zach Sackman enjoys the fact of the family going racing when there's also a national event going on. That means Matt's working in the pro ranks over in Topeka this weekend, and Zach gets the run. Hey, Cop Eliminator.
Competition Eliminator.
Cop Eliminator, need your lanes, please. Cop Eliminator, need you to the staging lanes, please. Pit. Staging lanes, please. I'll spit it out here in a minute. The Sackman brothers, Matt and Zach, splitting driving duties in the car. When there's a pro race going on, a national event on the Mellow Yellow Tour going on, Matt's hanging out in the pro ranks doing his job. Zach gets to play, the Hankstafers. Novak Electric Machine, they're on the left-hand side. Dave Jamison, out of Twinsburg. Pair of load guards, out of the gate, running. Sackman, 004, 606, 226 miles an hour. Dave Jamison, 616 at 225. The only thing I can really say about this weekend at our Oakland Competition Diamond Pistons Top Dragster is the record for the quickest ever field may be in serious jeopardy. The only thing, and even the wind seems to be dying down a little bit, and that ain't exactly a good thing, at least not for weather-wise. It is for the cars going down the racetrack, but we could, on this surface, with the air conditions that we have today, be looking at an all-time quick record field. Mr. Coughlin pulls up on the left-hand side of the racetrack. And Kathy Fisher over here on the right-hand side, the armor plate. How about a 6.06 at only 201 miles an hour down at the other end for Kathy. So she's up. So Kathy goes to number one. Sackman just comes to number two by 0.03 of a second. Three, 6.14. Dave Jamison, number four, to 6.16. Four cars down track, and the slowest is the 6.16. Hello. There's Dan Norris and Danny Waddle. Oh, this may get interesting before it's all over and done with. All I can say is, Mother Nature, please stay away. A couple more blown cars. Hemi-powered ride for Norris over on the left-hand side to Summit Lane out of Michigan. Danny Waddle over here on the right. Got the Chevrolet. Cop Eliminator, need your lanes, please. Cop to the lanes. Come on down. Danny Waddle, 6.14, 2.24. Danny Norris sidestepped it out of the gate and then shut it off about half track. Still goes 8.78 at 103. Lost his rubber band out there. Uh-oh. Well, I hate it when the rubber band breaks on my race toy. So everybody that has made it down track right now has made it down 6.16 or better. Whew. Dan Norris lost the blower pulley, a.k.a. the rubber band on his race toy. These guys stood 8.78 at 103 miles an hour. Retrieve said blower belt, check racetrack, make sure it's clean, green, mean, and ready to go. I'm telling you what, this track right now is about as mean as you can get. Comp. Comp Eliminator, need your lanes, please. Competition Eliminator, need you. Staging lanes, please. Come on down. Competition Eliminator. To the staging lanes, please. Racer. Don't forget, non-denominational chapel service Sunday morning. 7:30 and 9 a.m. services, two of them. Summit Side, the RFC trailer. And Kids RFC all day Saturday. And everyone is welcome. Here comes Michael Scheel. Michael, who had a most impressive weekend a couple of weeks ago down in Columbus. The Bantam-bodied, Hemi-powered Roadster. Mixing it up with all the boys with the long skinny cars and girls. And Michael just danced his way through round after round after round of elimination. Just missed winning the whole dang race. Tony Bellet on the left-hand side. Landscape contract. Mike Boz chassis machine. Oops. Well, it's not going to be good for Tony. Not going to be too bad for Michael. Michael, 623, 215 miles an hour. Michael in the 620s. Really? 215 miles an hour? Everybody else's teams are better. What are you doing? Oh, I know it's still good. For a short wheelbase, Bantam-bodied Roadster? Yeah. That's more than good. Shields goes to the number six spot with a 623. Brian Keller. The KB Trailer Sales. Centerless Grinding Solution. Blown Hemi 5, 470 plus combination. Spencer chassis car. Taking on Ed Dudley. Wonder if Ed Dudley's any relation to Dudley Do-Right of the Canadian Mavericks. Probably not. Dudley out of Plainfield, Indiana, the Spitzer chassis car over on the right-hand side. So a pair of Spitzers. Dudley on the baby on the bottle. He's got the nitrous oxide feeding into that Ford power system. Not exactly your conventional top dragster race car. How about Keller? 613, 232. 626, 213 for Dudley. So Dudley goes to number eight. Keller's in the number three spot. We just continue on hammering down. We've got blown cars, we've got injected cars, we've got pro charge cars. How about turbocharged diesel cars? We got one of them too, Jared Jones. Shy Diesel Service machine over there on the left-hand side. That is a twice-turboed plumber's nightmare. Go by the pits and take a look at it. That sucker has got more tubing and more lines and more fittings than, well, and now never mind, I'll leave politics out of it. Anyway, Jared on the left-hand side, Justin Mosier over here on the right, the Mosier Engineering Hot Rod with the Pro Charge combination. And it looks like Jared's got problems. The diesel gets shut off. Justin picking him up, putting him down for 1,320 feet, and he goes 619 at 219 miles an hour. Comp, we need your lanes, please. Competition Eliminator, need you to the staging lanes, please. Competition Eliminator, need you to the lanes. Boys and girls, guys and gals, ladies and gents, come on down. So we have now had 11 cars go down the racetrack. Out of that 11, nine of them have made it under power. And of those nine, the slowest is a 626. Shoot. Wait. comes Fireball Tom. Used to be called Angry Tom Fisher. Until he was trying to get a big block Chevrolet up and running. Kind of pushed the envelope a little bit. Got it fired up a little bit quicker than it should have been. Had a little bit of fuel in it. It spit it out on him. And well, Tom was a fireball. That was just a couple weeks ago. For RacingRVs.com. Tom will be coming up over on the Summit side of the racetrack. Jimmy Prevost out of Illinois, coming over from the land of Lincoln. We're at Morrison Powered Entry. 632 combination for Jimmy. Gotta tell you, Jim Prevost over here on the right-hand side with a very good weekend could actually become our Jags All-Star round. He's gotta go a bunch of rounds. But he's here and the guy in front of him ain't, is it? Do you get the idea? 636, 209 miles an hour by Jim, who is in foul on the reaction timer. 628 by Tom Fisher. Free through May 29th. Friendly reminder. And the boys just keep smacking. Some very good numbers out of the race cars going down the track. Kathy Fisher. Still leading the pack with that 6.065 run. Mike Trout rolling in now. Mike Trout's car, absolutely stunning. I love going to a drag race and having a car show breakout. The Alexandria, Kentucky-based runner. 655 cubic inch, bottle-fed Hemi. Frank Carpinelli out of Ohio, the undercover chassis car over there on the left-hand side. Carpinelli's hot rod got a little extra sneeze being blown into it. 638, 210 miles an hour by Mike as Trout motors through. Carpinelli a little off the pace with a 6.52 lap at 2.14. I say off the pace, well, only because everybody else is in the 30s or better. And he's in the 50s. Still good numbers, don't get me wrong. But just nigh on to incredible. Bobby Ray McMahon, Lodi, California-based runner. And Philip Oakley. Another Ford-powered machine, another Texas Roadhouse car for the Oakley Competition Gang. Purging a little nitrous out to balance the system on the Ford for Oakley. Texas Roadhouse. How about a 12-ounce filet, medium rare? Baked, oh, never mind. Ooh. Bobby Ray got up on the tires, spoke them a little bit. How about Oakley, 6.22 at 2.13. As he muscles his way in, Bobby Ray goes 009 at the tree. Goes on to the sheet, albeit down at the bottom of the sheet, with a 7.10 lap. at 217 miles an hour. 710 sounds like an old AM radio station, doesn't it? WHB. JB Strasweg, Ryan Smith, Ryan out of Kenosha. Just checking to make sure that he didn't have a Rambler motor in it since he's from Kenosha. I mean, hey, you know. Rolla Competition Engines, Brad Anderson combination. JB got the Meyer Distributing. I was talking to him yesterday. I said, what is Meyer Distributing? He said, think of it as the summit for the trucking industry. Top Sportsman, need you to lanes, please. Top Sportsman, to the lanes. JB goes through 623, 211 miles an hour, 655 for Ryan. On a 202 mile an hour lap. He was telling me some incredible stuff for the guys at Meyer Distributing. They're like the world's largest WeatherTech dealer, and they turn their inventory, their entire inventory, every 8 days. And I'm like, that's a lot of WeatherTech. I mean, crazy. Tony Elrod rolling in now, the S&W chassis machine. There's our blown cars getting ready to roll up as Andrew Johnson alongside. The bridge. Indiana, Kentucky. Based runner. On your phone or at home. Over Jake's Sports Nat champ over here on the right hand side, the Budweiser lane. Ooh, problems for Tony. He's going nowhere slowly. 616, 224 for Andrew. So Andrew's going to jump up there onto the top page. 1236, 108 by Tony Elrod. Andrew's going to jump in. Number six on the qualifying sheet. Live tracks and manned insights now. Exclusively on the Fleetwood. 21 cars down track so far. For those of you not familiar with our Oakley Competition, Diamond Pistons, top dragster ranks. We qualify the quick 32. Normal conditions, a qualifier today, a couple more tomorrow. And eliminations on Sunday, obviously, with the weather being somewhat imminent. We'll just kind of have to play it by ear. Merlin Brown rolling up now, the runner out of Lisbon, Ohio, over on the right-hand side. Innovative chassis works car. Got the big motored Chevrolet sitting behind the runner out of Lisbon, Ohio. And left-hand side, Tim Antonotta. Tim's got problems. Shakes a little bit, shuts off. Merlin shuts off. We go 0 for 2, 715. 139 for Merlin. 899, 94 miles an hour for Timmy. They'll go on down at the bottom of the sheet. Kathy Fisher still leading the pack. All the boys at this point in time lined up behind the lady.